Hi folks, thanks very much for joining me for this week's Stillwater tutorial. In the vise you see a small wet fly, an excellent alternative to a hare's ear or a dial back even. So without further ado, let's get into it. In the vise then you see a Hanak H260 barbless hook. This one's at size 12. It's a heavy wire hook and it's in black nickel. The thread I'm going to be using today is the Veevus. It's the E01 and it's at 8-0. First thing I'm going to do is get a little bit of wax and just wax up the end of my thread. Now, the 260 comes up a lot shorter than a Kamazan 175. So when you're buying your hooks, you need to bear that in mind. This is more akin to a size 14 in the old Kamazan 175 money. So worth bearing in mind. So I'm just laying a bed of thread down, all the way down the shank, till I've come to approximately where a barb would be on a hook. Then I'll simply remove my waste. Now I'm going to be using Partridge for my tailing feathers, and I've got my cape here and I'm taking the Partridge feather for the tailing off the top here, and I've already selected a feather. Now the reason I take it from the top is it's a lot darker and I don't have much use for these bigger feathers, so they make ideal tailing. So I've already cleaned all the fluff away and I'm going to take a healthy pinch and just pull it off at a right angle. Then I can grab it all, and there I've got myself a nice little partridge tail. So I'm going to dress that up, and I want it to protrude approximately 1 centimetre past the bend of the hook. I'll just get that in, then move my thumb and forefinger, just to make sure I'm happy with the proportion. Then before I come up, I can simply trim that away, and then come all the way back up to the thorax area. Next, I'm going to use some UTC Ultra Wire. This is copper and it's small. I've already got a little piece off here that I've been working with, and I'm going to catch that in just in the thorax there on my side. Bring it all the way back to the butt of the fly. So the dubbing I'm going to be using is my old favourite. It's the from Troutstalkers, and it's the natural boosted. I've already got a little pinch out. I'm sure if you follow the channel, you'll have seen this many times. It's my favourite dubbing, natural dubbing. It's superb. So I'm just going to take a very small pinch of that. You don't need much. And I'm going to dub that on. It's a really nice natural dub, this. Don't want too much, but I want enough is that when I have come up the body, I can get my dubbing brush in there and really fluff it out. So I'm going to stop there at the thorax area, and I'm going to bring my wire in the opposite direction to the way my dubbing went on. And I have been guilty in the past of saying that and then going in entirely the opposite direction, but I think I've got it right today. So once I've secured my wire ribbon, I can twist that away, keep tension on the thread, and it will come straight off. So next then, before I go on, I'm going to come in with my dubbing brush, keeping my hands on my bobbin, and just rough out that body. Don't be too worried if you catch your tail. And then just brush everything back. And that'll get it all out the way for the next stage of the fly. So on this fly, I'm going to add some Glo-Brite No4 as cheeks. And all you do with this is take off about 4 or 5 inches. Doesn't even need to be that much actually, but just for ease of use, fold it in half, and you can do it a number of ways. I'll catch in on my side and just make sure it's lengthened up, and then bend it back around to your side, excuse my fingers for a second, and bring it forward. Now, depending on how big you want your thorax, depends on how far you want to come back with your thread at this point. And I'm fairly happy with that. Again, a little bit more off the scruffy dubbing at the front of the fly. Just dub it on. And I maybe want just slightly more than I've picked up there. So come back. And that should do the job. So next then, I'm going to bring the dubbing forward and build a little bit of a thorax. I'm leaving plenty of room at the front because I've still got to tie in my cheeks and my hackle at the front. So grab a hold of your Glo-Brite, pull it all forward, and just capture that in. Couple of turns in front of the material, and then you can remove your waste. Now before I go on, just going to open my vise and have a look and see what you're seeing. Yep, I'm fairly pleased with that. I've got a nice bright orange cheek there, but I don't want it to be that in your face. So what I'm going to do is add a hackle to this fly. And again, I take the hackle from the bottom of the cape at this point. And again, there's a reason for that. The feathers at the very bottom are much smaller, and I'll get the size of hackle I require. So what I'm going to do is come in with my hackle pliers, just grab the tip of the feather and pull it all back. Just take a little bit of time to get this bit right, but eventually what you'll end up with, and I'll show you in a minute, I know this is completely out of focus, but when I show you, you'll see what I mean. So I've got it back like so, and that's where I'm going to tie it in. So I'll just grab my little bit here. Now before I do that, just going to add the tiniest amount of wax to the thread. I don't want to put too much wax on because it does affect the colour of the head then. So I'm dressing that up where I've got the feather. I'm going to come over carefully, bend back the tag end, get a couple of turns in front, and then if I so wish, I can come in and just remove the tag with my scissors here. Now, because the tag's so small at this point, I'm going to leave it. It just adds to the cloak of the wing. Grab your hackle pliers, or you can just use the handle if you've got that kind of motor skills. I haven't, so I like to use the hackle pliers. Sometimes the tag's too big and it needs to be cut, but on this occasion, I've made a nice, neat, small tag, so I don't need to worry about it. Now I'm going to bring it over one turn, one half turn actually, and then sweep back and just encourage the hackle fibres to go back. So that's one turn. I want to get two turns on this fly at this size. You know, different size of flies require different amounts of turns, but two is just perfect for this fly. And then once I've got two in, I'm going to just work my thread through the hackling, and once I've got it into place, I can get two turns to lock it in. I'm going to remove my hackle pliers, slick everything back with my thumb and forefinger, and then just start to build the head. Now before I go on, I want to obviously remove my handle here. I'm going to carefully come in with the scissors and take that away. and then I can concentrate on finishing the head off. Once you've got it reasonably to the right size, you can come in with your whip finish tool and 1, 2, 3, finish that off. Now, I could have added a little bit of varnish before, you know, to the thread and then whip finished and cured it. But I like to just do this one just at the end. So I've got some UV resin here. This is, I know there's no label and people always ask me, so I'll just tell you now, it's Solaris UV Bone Dry, or Bone Cure, I think it's called. It's been that long since the label fell off. I've forgotten myself, but I can just come in with a little brush, open the vise up, get your resin on, locate your UV torch, and just cure that off. Now this is a great wee fly. As I said at the very start of the video, it's ideal for an alternative to a hare's ear pattern, and it works really well in the margins amongst the weed and stuff. So I would fish this generally in a team, maybe on the top dropper or in the middle, but it would always be on a washing line or something like that. It works really well, and it's definitely worth adding to your box. So once you've cured the head, simply come in with the brush, your dubbing brush, and you can titivate it up to your heart's content. Now, if I'd been a little bit more generous with the dubbing, it would have been a much bushier fly when dry, but when wet, it slims right down to nothing, and it's perfect. Thanks very much for watching. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, please think about clicking the button. I would really appreciate it.